95 million years ago, an animal came by and placed their print right in that mud, and yeah, they left their mark. So that's a track. It's actually a bit of a treasure hunt. I'm kind of having fun now that I've found a couple. Now I really want to find more. So.
My journey begins at North America's most northern drivable point. The plan is to ride through Canada and America before crossing over to Europe. From there, I'll make my way across Asia and down to Australia. New Zealand's southernmost drivable point will mark the end of my journey. I'm calling it the Big Spiral, and this is Act 3, Across North America.
All right, the bike started this morning. How exciting. Okay, so I gotta do that one thing in Dawson before we head to Tumbler Ridge. And I gave you a little hint earlier. It has to do with the Alaska Highway. So turn left here. So I think it's up there somewhere. So there you can see it right there. You are now entering the world famous Alaska Highway. And I need to get myself a picture with that sign. So this is basically mile zero of Alaska Highway. And of course I need to get a shot with my motorbike. So this is essentially mile zero of Alaska Highway. So I kind of did it all out of order, but I've pretty much done the whole Alaska Highway. So it basically starts from here and finishes in Fairbanks. So I just wanted to get a shot with the sign, because it's kind of, you know, the thing to do when you drive the Alaska Highway. How do I do this? It's a bit silly, isn't it? Oh, that's better. Oh, that's better. Oh, yeah. So it's just reading a plaque, and actually the mile zero marker is right in the middle of that roundabout. And originally it was a white pole, but then it got hit by a car. So then, then I guess they erected that statue over there. All right, so I've done the touristy thing. Got my picture next to the sign. Now it's time to head to Tumbler Ridge. And I'm kind of excited for that, because there's a lot of cool things all kind of packed into one place that you can go check out. And maybe the one I'm most interested in is these dinosaur tracks. So basically, many years ago, back when the dinosaurs were roaming around, they were roaming around here. And when they were roaming around here, they were walking through the mud. Well, this mud has since turned to stone. And you can still see their tracks in the stone. So I thought that was really cool, and something I definitely want to check out. And you know, the thing is about this place, it's quite windy today. I've never really heard of it until I started researching places to ride, because this is actually a pretty popular place to take your motorcycle. So it seemed like a pretty good combo of motorcycling and kind of exploring and checking out the interesting things to see. So yeah. Geopark. All right, so our first stop is a massive waterfall, even bigger than the waterfall yesterday. At least I think so. From what I've seen in pictures, it's really, really quite impressive. So Okay, change of plans. Dinosaur tracks first. Sweet! I realized, I thought they're gonna be sort of in the middle of the route, but actually it should be the start of the route.
So dinosaurs are pretty cool, right? So apparently these tracks have existed for 95 million years, which is seems just insane. Like, how did they just... It just seems so fortunate that they've lasted that long and they're on the surface and they're somewhere we can see them. So even though the tracks are so old, they were only discovered 24 years ago in the year 2000 by two boys that were just tubing down the river. And apparently the story goes is that they fell off their tube and had to walk back up the river and saw these tracks in I guess in the rock. So they contacted they contacted a paleontologist, and then the paleontologist is like, yep, you found some dinosaur tracks. I don't know about you, but when I was a kid, I did not have the ability to contact a paleontologist. I wouldn't know where to begin. Barely had the internet back then. Oh, sorry. Flatbed Creek, dinosaur footprint sites. Are they just on the rock here? Oh, there, already. Is that it? Is that it? It doesn't look like a footprint. Maybe it is. We're here too? Okay, maybe it's something down here. Lots of people walking around. It does seem like these very well could be dinosaur prints. But maybe there's another path going this way, going to, it says original dinosaur trackway viewpoint. So, yeah, maybe all this is dinosaur tracks. Like, there's more of these ripples here. I don't really know though, because it also looks like, you know, the ripples at the bottom of a creek. But okay, so I was just discussing it with them and I have like a little map. So that's definitely a track, but then down here it's way more obvious. So that's a track. And I'm pretty sure this is too. It's actually a bit of a treasure hunt. I'm kind of having fun now that I've found a couple. Now I really want to find more. So I have my little map here. So two on that rock there, two here. Oh, I think they're all up here. And then I can walk down there and there's going to be a bunch. Okay. Oh, here's more. So I just found these as well. So actually they pop up pretty good when there's water on them. So yeah, there's a track right there. This is three toes. Like, yeah, I can't do that. Three toes. And then these must be tracks as well. It took me a bit to figure out, but they are here.
It's right there, one.
Yeah, oh, you got it so fast. Yeah, and I think this one's here too.
Yeah.
And I think that might be one as well. And then if you go down that corner there, There's at least three down there. Yeah. Well, apparently I wouldn't make a very good paleontologist because they were right under my nose and I was like, I don't see anything. Maybe they need to paint them for me. So apparently there's three types of dinosaurs that left their tracks there. So if I can say it properly, ornithopods, theropods, and ankylosaurs. To me, the most obvious print was from the theropod because they have the three toes. And yeah, it's just like, it almost looks like a leaf or something. But yeah, to think that these dinosaurs were walking 95 million years ago, an animal came by and placed their print right in that mud
And yeah, they left their mark that I'm looking at 95 million years ago. Now, I'm pretty sure anything that I do is not going to last 95 million years. So, anyways, it's cool to kind of think about Earth in that kind of time frame, because we only see like what's around us, and we only think about history within, I don't know, maybe the last 1,000 years or so, 10,000 if you're lucky. But the Earth is an old place, and these giant lizards walking on their hind legs were walking around where I am right now 95 million years ago. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. But anyways, let's go to our next stop, the waterfalls, I believe.
All right, so it's 60K to the waterfall, and I think mostly gravel, which I'm going to enjoy, I think. Oh dear. Canusio Falls, I think that's how you pronounce it. Oh, there's the gravel. At the parking lot, I suppose. All right, let's check out Canusio Falls. I can hear them already. Apparently it's 75 meters tall, which is pretty high. Just looking over here, and I think you can start to see them a bit. Just start to see it crest over. All right, we gotta keep walking. Why? The best spot, the best viewing spot is closed. Oh, maybe it's not the best viewing spot. You can just see over the edge here. All right, I have to keep going down, but the rest of the trail is not maintained. So I'm gonna have to be careful with my squeaky boots. Where does this even go? That just goes straight down a cliff. This goes to fallen trees. Oh. Is it steep? I saw it, I looked that way, it looked crazy steep.
It's like that.
Did you guys make it all the way to the water? No, is it really too steep?
No,
they're
in their shoes.
Okay, I'm not wearing good shoes either. Ooh, I got a warning about steepness. Maybe I should have put my other shoes on. You'd think they'd have a better trail to view these falls, because that viewpoint up there, you can't even see them. They're just, you just see the top. All right. Yeah, look at this hill. Hello. You'd think they'd have a better trail for these falls, eh?
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah. Isn't that a sight? It's so amazing. I find it's always super difficult to tell the scale of a waterfall from video. So it always helps to try to place a person in the shot somewhere so you can kind of see how big it is compared to that person. So if you look in your bottom left of the frame, all right, now I gotta hike back up this in my squeaky boots.
It was worth it.
It was cool.
It was really cool.
Yeah. Whew. All right, well, that was probably the best waterfall thus far, actually. Yeah, well, definitely the biggest, that's for sure. It's 5 o'clock now. So I think I'm gonna, there's actually a campground right here. So I think I'm gonna set up camp here, and it's time for bed. So, yeah. All right, I think we're gonna end the video here. Tomorrow we're gonna head into the mountains, and yeah, mountains are good.